left, ratchet to death. Hoods on the right, wild for the night. Punks in the back, come on in the track to what? Clan in the front, let your feet stomp. Niggas on the left, ratchet to death. Hoods on the right, wild for the night. Punks in the back, come on in the track to what?
How you doing? My name is Derek B. Harden, and you're at Gallery 151 at the first ever Wu-Tang brand art show. The show is called Grassroots Through the Womb. And I'm going to walk you through the show a bit. Starting off, the first piece that you see in Grassroots Through the Womb is the footprints. And the footprints with the W represents how Wu-Tang came in the game and stomped their way into the business of the music business, the hip-hop business. Moving on, you have the abstract, colorful expression that Wu-Tang delivers from all that they do. So we have the footprints, then we move on to the abstract expression. From the abstract expression that these men have used, they've given birth to a lot of other different artists within their genre. You know, the list goes forever. But the main thing is that they gave birth to a lot of different other rap crews and rap soloists. So as that happens, Wu-Tang continues their creative expression, very colorful, very abstract, but still the norm, as you see here. Then moving forward from the next abstract phase, and we go into the phase of act now, the taste, the victory, the pleasure. So this is the excitement part, as you see that. Then we're moving into the actual celebration. So if you see, this is the celebration. This is when the money came. The good times, the dancing, this is how the money came. And how did they make that money? They made that money from putting out the records. These are the records. From putting out the records, they became, as this piece shows, engraved, as I would put it, in the street culture. Not pop culture yet, but the street culture is what they were a part of. So this is just a graffiti piece of the actual W in street culture. Now, everybody loves Wu-Tang, and we all want to know who did it. So these are the lineup of men who did it. We got RZA, Method Man, Raekwon, Ghostface, ODB, rest in peace, U-God, Inspector Deck, Master Killer, Capadonna, and GZA. These are the men that created and were the face of the Wu-Tang Clan. Proceeding on to that, what every good thing has its up and downs. So with all this brotherhood, you know, comes the samurai who stabs himself, creating the division within the clan, which always happens with any group. Creating the division in the clan. So that's what the piece represents here with the samurai stabbing himself, is the division in the actual clan. From that division, one is left in, you know, a maze. One is left in purgatory. And this piece right here represents the purgatory, the maze of after the stabbing of thyself. So that piece reflects that. Moving along, after the phase, and after the maze, and the phase of the maze, in the purgatory, we lead into a great cloud. This great cloud reads, heal the sick, raise the dead, cast out the demons. Oh shit. From the great cloud, we move into a sun ray. An abstract sun ray. So we're still shining. So that's what that represents for Wu, is that they're still shining, they're still here. Even though you see the black raindrops, it's still hard times, but we're still shining through those hard times. Now, what happens when you're shining and you're a celebrity or a likable person? You get your groupies. These are the Wu-Tang groupies. They all melted. So moving along, when you got groupies, what's the best side dish for groupies? You got Japanese cocaine, wasabi. So that's where the fun happened. Japanese cocaine, Usagi. Now moving along from that, we learned that Wu-Tang is no longer just a part of street culture, now they're a part of pop culture. So they're now literally tattooed on the culture of pop. And this is what this piece represents. Wu-Tang being tattooed on the game. They're officially in. They are pop culture. Moving along, we're still delivering hot and fresh, fast, still giving it to you. Now as we continue to give it to you hot and fresh and fast, we come to the mirror. The mirror is the reflection of Wu-Tang. The mirror is the reflection of culture. When you look in the mirror of the culture, you see Wu-Tang. Coming off of the reflection of Wu-Tang is the actual statement that Wu-Tang is hip-hop. They're official. They're officially hip-hop. From that statement, they went platinum. Wu-Tang went platinum. So if you see that, Wu-Tang went platinum. This is a more colorful abstract because this is where Wu-Tang makes the money, and 420, Wu-Tang smokes it. And then, you know, things get low, we gotta do what we gotta do, and we continue to have our colorful abstract expression, creating more finances for us, which means more chaos and more ups and downs. But that's the beauty of life. So that's what that represents. And that brings us to the last piece of the actual show in its lineage of speech, is the door. Is Wu-Tang brand back at the door of the culture, knocking on the door of the culture. And it explains grassroots through the womb. And that is the end of the show.
TV. My name is Marwa. I'm here with Kel at Gallery 151 here on 350 Bowery Street. He's going to tell us a little bit about his artwork. He actually did a tribute to all the Wu-Tang members. So let's take it one by one. Kel, what inspired you to do, you know, individual canvases of all the Wu-Tang members?
I mean, basically, the clan is the truth. A Protect Your Neck came out like 92. In 92, I was in the streets just running wild, and this was my soundtrack.
You were influenced.
Influence. Absolutely. Influence is not even a word. Like, the Clan is the truth. It's, to me, they're the greatest hip-hop group ever, of all time, to ever do it, so.
It seemed like you really took the time to put some character into each individual picture, like, about the person. You made Method Man, like, you know, his mouth's open, he seems real excited. Is this how you view him?
Absolutely. Meth got the gold fangs,
yeah.
You know? Suck the blood out of the vampires on the world.
You know.
I mean, RZA's,
you see him very low key.
RZA and GZA down there, you know, I guess we'll get to at the end. They're the biggest canvases out of it. So they basically, they're like the heads of the clan. You know, the RZA, the GZA, and Dirty. And Dirty has got the middle, you know. Dirty,
yeah,
forget Raccoon.
No, definitely not. He's a thinker. You made him a thinker.
That's the duo right there. Ray said he was the first one to do that. The Malcolm X pose.
I really like this because you made it black and white, you changed it, and you put it right in the middle. Tell us why you did this.
I actually have a Dirty piece, an old Dirty piece that's the same colors as this that goes along with the whole set. But we chose to go with this one. I painted this one as well after he passed away and whatnot.
Put a little halo, I like that.
Absolutely. I mean, Old Dirty was like one of the craziest MCs where his style was just
raw.
All over the place. Raw.
Raw.
Oh, baby, I like it raw.
That's the best song.
No, he was just all over the place,
yeah.
with his style. So, you know, he brought a lot to the game. So he had to get...
Is there any symbolism in like, the drops? Like, is it supposed to symbolize, like, sadness at all?
Not necessarily. I mean, it's just more style. But, I mean, maybe you can see the drips here going up to heaven. Or I don't know. If you want to rock with that?
Yeah.
All right, we're rocking with that.
All right.
That's Baby Huey.
Yes.
Golden arms. He's got the golden fists.
All right, good. So.
You know, you gotta do Baby Huey.
And again, this is Kel. He did all these.
Antonio Kel, Five and Meats.
Oh, Antonio Kel.
So could be the full name.
Sure. Well, it's nice meeting you.
Nice to meet you too.
Definitely, we love your artwork. We're here at Gallery 151 with Boo TV. Watching Boo TV. We're here with Master Killer. How do you feel about the art show tonight?
The art show is beautiful. It's another level. It's another chamber. It's the art form that's been long lost. You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
As far as art, as far as the music, as far as everything, it's just vintage. You know.
And the Wu-Tang Clan itself, because the name of the show is actually Grassroots, back or through the womb. Why don't you tell us a little bit about how your own creative vision separated you from your clan?
Well, my own creativeness is a combination of my brothers. You know what I mean? But I just express it through my individual self. You know what I mean? It's like I'm the born member, which makes everything complete. You know, everything goes from now as the born, from one to nine. You know what I mean? So. All those styles are basically within myself and expressed through myself, but I'm the master of all that shit.
Absolutely. What kind of things can we expect from your new album that's coming out this fall?
You can expect classic hip-hop,
original.
Of course.
Yeah, absolutely.
And you can expect beautiful music.
Here we have DJ Nicole Leone. It's a pleasure to meet you.
It's a pleasure to meet you.
She's been DJing for 10 years. She's from New Zealand. She's been DJing around New York City.
Yep. I worked in New Zealand when Wu-Tang, you know, first came out. I was working in the music industry in New Zealand.
How long ago was that?
That was in the 90s, like in the, you know, the early to mid 90s. So we've been Wu-Tang fans for a long time.
Why don't you show me one of your favorite ones? So I believe this was your favorite one, huh?
This is my favorite one. I like this one. So, I mean, actually, it's kind of hard to choose because there's a lot of very bright, colorful ones. It depends what room you were looking at. I would have this one in the bedroom, though, I think.
Absolutely. It is a little suggestive.
Nice.
What do you like most about it?
It's erotic. I mean, it's exotic, but it's like...
What do you get from the picture?
Just shows like the shape of how circles, like that round shape is everywhere, like in nature and, you know, in graphic design. And I just think it's really sexy. But there's a bunch that I like.
We have the artist right here. What is your name?
Tobias Batts.
Tobias. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you. This is Wu TV. We're on Wu TV.
This is inspired by the Wu-Tang.
All right, why don't you tell us what inspired you to use a woman's rear end?
That's my
how
thing.
How did you get that photo of me? That's what I want to know.
My work is a respectful celebration of the female form. And I really was inspired by the shape of the logo with her shape of her ass.
Okay, so he included some of the shapes from the logo, the roundness. Incorporate it into...
I just thought it fit nicely.
And is this like a fingerprint?
It's a half-toning technique that I use, and it's spray-painted, the logo is spray-painted on top of the inkjet print.
Yo, Ninth Prince is in the building. What's good, y'all? Representing my peoples, you know what I mean?
All right, and you brought your friend here, is Lord?
Yeah, what up, world? You know, we're just in the house, just chilling, you know what I mean?
It's Lord, and we're here at Gallery 151. We're having the Wu-Tang exhibit. What do you think about the artwork?
Yeah, I love the artwork. I think it's very creative, and I respect it. You know, I respect the people that created this and took the time to, you know, to sit there and draw all this stuff. It's hot, man. I love it. You know what I mean? Art is very important. We need that, you know, for the hip hop culture. You know what I mean? And life in general. Period. You know what I mean? So, you know what I mean? Everybody out there, go out there and support real art. You know what I mean? What up, man?
Are you gonna do any kind of event to? Promote your album?
Oh, definitely, man. You're going to see me all online. You know what I mean? Catch me coming to a hood near you doing shows and all that, too. You know
what's
what I
the
mean?
Name of it again?
It's the Salute the General EP. That's coming in early May. And then I got the Shaolin Prince album coming in like around October, fourth quarter. You know what I mean?
So what is Salute the General about? It's about staying original?
It's about staying original and being a leader. You know what I mean?
Just like Wu-Tang.
Exactly. You know, I started the killer army, so I'm the general. You know what I mean? So, you know, in life, you know, we got to lead. You know what I mean? No doubt.
You're here with Kathy Wilson and Wu TV. I'm here with Tim Saputo.
Accelerator creative director, and I would like to ask him what his favorite piece is here and why.
This is my favorite piece. Not really sure why. I just feel drawn to it. And
you like that part of the woman's body?
I do. I like that part of the woman's body.
You like a nice round, supple ass?
Yes. And
what man doesn't like a nice round, supple ass with a Wu-Tang mark on it?
That's a good question. That's a really good question. But yeah.
Would you consider yourself an art collector?
No, I don't actually own any art.
So then it's a big compliment that this is the piece that you like. That means of all the other art pieces, that's not being somebody that's a pro at art, this is the one you decided.
Yes.
Well, thank you for your thoughts.
You're welcome. Thank you for having me.
All right. That's Tim Sabuto, creative director of Accelerator Magazine, and me, Kathy Wilson. Hi, this is Marwa with Wu TV. We're here with Young Dirty Bastard. How are you?
I'm good, y'all. Peace.
Good. And how do you feel about the gallery, the artwork, your dad's presence?
Tell you the truth, this is my first time here, you know. Right now, as you can see, you got the halo, you know, he's living good. Wherever he at right now, everything in peace.
Rest in peace.
It's beautiful out here. A lot of people came to show love, that's true, you know. I like that.
Yeah, the turnout was amazing. So what do you plan on doing with your career, or living on your dad's legend?
My album about to come out. Trying to make it come out probably July. You know what I'm saying? I'm about to shoot a video and all that. Young Dirty Bastard.
July. What's the name of your album?
I think I'm going to call it Planet Freedom. 20 years of pregnancy.
And the legend is reborn. Hi, it's Marwa with Wu TV. I'm here with one of the spectators at the gallery. What is your name?
Amira.
Amira?
Yes.
Have you gotten a chance to look around yet?
I've done a quick little run through and saw some of the art. It's really cool. This is actually my friend's art, Jaskon De Lima. He's one of the artists, so I just came to see his stuff tonight. I'm really impressed. There's a lot of really cool, eclectic stuff out there.
What's your favorite piece? Favorite one? And you're the artist. What's your name?
My name is Jaskon, aka Hypno.
Alright. So I like the fact that you made your painting on a record. That's hot.
Well, I feel like there's a relationship between music and art that's very, very similar to like any expressive thing that you do. So like, I feel like it's just a representation of what goes hand in hand, like especially with like Wu-Tang and hip hop music, you know, graffiti, it's all one.
So you definitely linked its relationship through your artwork.
Yeah.
That's very creative. This is Christina. What brought you to the gallery tonight?
Wu-Tang. 1993, as soon as I graduated high school, Wu-Tang Clan dropped when I was a little club kid. Been a part of my life ever since. It was when I was growing up. It was that turn of, you know, little girl to wanting to be a woman.
Yeah.
And they've stayed with me throughout.
That's what music's supposed to do for you. I love your ensemble.
Thank you so much, and I so appreciate
that.
I totally appreciate you taking the time. I love this exhibit. It's so huge and important. I want Wu-Tang to just go on forever, and I think they will.
Oh, absolutely. Yes. Hi, I'm Marwa. You're watching Wu TV. We're here with some of the people affiliated with Wu-Tang, the legend. We're here at Gallery 151. Here behind me I have Taji and Sean Powers. They skate. Wu-Tang is actually a sponsor. So they're going to tell us a little bit about where they skate, what inspired them to collaborate with Wu-Tang. So where do you guys skate around New York City?
The five boroughs, everywhere, anything.
Pretty much anywhere you can imagine someone skating or not even imagine them skating, we're there skating.
What's your favorite borough to skate in?
Manhattan.
I gotta say Manhattan too.
Is it because you have the biggest like presence there?
I mean, it's just like better skating, better ground, more spots, just it's got it together, right?
All walks of life too, you know, you could just be skating on a block, see some crazy ass people. Some crackheads, some artists, whatever, anything, everybody.
That's
graffiti,
New York,
New York. That's it.
So what have you been doing longer, skating or listening to Wu-Tang?
I've been doing them both.
Yeah, both.
About the same amount of time.
I can't remember how long I've really been skating, and I can't remember how long I've been listening to Wu-Tang, so it's got to be, I don't know.
They're both just a passion, part of your life, right?
Yeah, my life.
Hell yeah. And skating, like, goes hand in hand with Wu-Tang. Like, you listen to some Wu-Tang, you watch some skating at the same time, like, it's just going to flow.
Wu-Tang influenced by martial arts and mafia flicks. My skateboarding influenced by martial arts, Wu-Tang style and mafia flicks.
So you definitely listen to Wu-Tang while you're skating then?
Of course.
Oh, hell yeah.
Course,
you see us, we got the headphones in, we're bumping Wu-Tang all day, skating all day. It keeps us running.
All right, well, thank you so much. Stay real.
Thank you.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Marwa. You're watching Wu TV. We're here at Gallery 151 in front of one of these gorgeous carving exhibits with Fiona Bloom. She was one of the first DJs down south to use Wu-Tang's album, Enter the 36 Chambers. Tell us how you incorporated that into your music and your turntables.
Wow. Well, it was in Atlanta on a radio station called WRFG. I'm actually from London originally, but when I lived in Atlanta, I got on the radio, and I'll never forget this. It was back in 1993. I'm only 26, by the way. This is back in 1993, one of the Loud representatives, Loud RCA Records, brought me this record and said, I need you to play this for me. I looked at it, all I saw was like a test press of Enter the 36 Chambers, Protect Your Neck, right? That was the B-side. Big W, Protect Your Neck. I was like, let me throw this on because it looked good. The minute I hit the needles with that record, I was like, oh yeah, this is my jam. I played it religiously for like 6 weeks straight, and literally one of the only DJs in the South that was playing Wu-Tang Clan, because it was getting some college radio play, some community radio, no commercial radio would touch it, and all of us were like getting credit for doing it. And because my show was so popular in Atlanta, I kind of made it really popular and got the name really out there. So it gave me a lot of sort of press and authenticity as a hip-hop DJ. And then from Method Man, you know, came Ghostface and RZA and GZA and everybody else that I got introduced to, so it was really, really cool. And I've literally been following the Wu-Tang's career since 1993, every single year. So every time a new record came out, I always played it. When I moved to New York, I followed their streetwear, their merch, them with the skateboarding, their first time in the video game arena, and I'm really, really proud to see their progression and them staying relevant in hip-hop culture, which is really important.
Have you ever taken the work into London, brought your music with Wu-Tang? Is the influence as heavy over there?
Oh my God, are you kidding me? It's even more mad than it is here. Especially around the world, in Japan, in Brazil, in France. I mean, I've traveled all over the world. Me coming from England, anything Wu, they like, down. And just the W, they want the sneakers, the shirts, the hoodies, the whole get-up.
Guys, Wu-Tang goes worldwide.
It's the cream, you know what I mean? Cash rules everything around me. Get the money, darling.
Exactly. And this is Fiona Bloom, DJ from Atlanta.
And now a publicist in New York. My company's called The Bloom Effect. Worked with a lot of great artists back in the day, including Gangsta.
Yeah, you gave me your card. That was nice.
So, yeah. And can I just say, I'm really happy to see the crowd tonight. Because even though Wu has been from the beginning of hip-hop culture, 20 years, it's still very fresh, and most of the crowd are younger than 25, which is amazing to me, because usually when you have legendary artists in the hip-hop game, it's a lot of old-school audiences that come out and represent. This is old and the new, and that to me is really, really beautiful, and really just further reiterates what Wu-Tang is
about. Shows how timeless they are.
How timeless they are. And it's another 20 years from here, and there's 20 more years from there. So I look at it as 2046. Woo! Woo!
The legend lives on.
Yeah, exactly. So.
So nice meeting with you.
Yeah, Marwa, thank you.
Thank you for all your energy. You're great. Hi, this is Marwa. You're watching Wu TV. I'm here at Gallery 151 with Derek and Laura. They're the directors and the curators for the gallery.
Yeah.
What do you have to say about tonight? It was a really great turnout.
Tonight is amazing night. Tonight we displayed the culture of hip hop and art through Gallery 151 and the Wu-Tang brand.
And do you think things went smoothly? I mean,
yes. With every great party, there I seem to physically have to remove somebody from the space. I cursed out one crazy guy because he was like, oh, I can't come in because my pants aren't baggy and I have a fitted. And I was like,
ignorant.
This big white dude. I was like, get the fuck out of here. But other than that, that's what we're fighting against. Yeah. Because when you bring urban culture into an environment like this, mixed with the, you know, the Wu-Tang brand and the W, it gives emerging artists a platform to be heard in a way they've never been heard before.
Exactly, and to keep it original and...
Yeah, the main thing is to just...
stay humble.
Not even humble. It's not to be boastful, but it's letting the W be a platform for other artists other than musicians. You know, these are the visuals that are created. So I think that that is a great platform for up-and-coming and emerging artists.
Yeah, and it expresses hip-hop in every single form of its generations.
Yeah, it definitely does. It definitely does.
And this is the first of many collaborations to come. And the Wu-Tang brand, Grassroots Through the Womb, is, you know, the beginning of the brand being able to collaborate with, you know, emerging visual artists in different ways. So we did it here at Gallery 151 first.
No, you guys did a great job. I mean, just coming in, I saw the first painting I saw was the footsteps, and I was like, oh, footsteps of Wu-Tang, you know?
Yeah, no,
like,
that
tells
means,
a story.
That means the stomping, that's the impact that they made from stomping on the game.
They left their footprints.
And then when you look at it, it goes into the colorful expression, and then it gives birth to many other different artists. So, I mean, it reads so well, the actual show.
Yeah.
So it's an amazing piece of work. And
did you guys find the artists, or did they? Was it like an open submission?
No, there was no open submission. It was word of mouth. You know, we had like a pool that the gallery was trying to do.
You found some great people.
Thank you. And then Derek contacted some people, and then it was really a collaborative effort. You know, 50-50, like, and then the artists. Word of mouth, like if we got one artist in,
tell a friend,
and do you have any Wu pieces? You
know, that's how networking works. Yeah,
exactly.
My personal favorites are those carvings. He said it takes just 50 hours just to carve the wood printing.
The wood alone.
Yeah,
yeah, it takes 50 hours.
And he actually makes
that's
the paper
dedication.
And everything. Yeah,
he's amazing. Patrick is amazing. I'm very proud of the show. I'm very proud to be a part of my own experience. Yeah, you know.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much. You guys did actually an amazing job.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah. I had an amazing time here.
Gallery 151, Wu-Tang Brand.
Grassroots Through the Womb.
Thank you.